arrangement, and I do believe that the Libyan gold was a major target of our attack.
All right. Sorry, go ahead, Paul.
I said I believe that too. Because he wanted to start the.
I mean, we now have the State Department emails. Good to hear from you, Paul. I mean, we're just proven right again, just over and over again. And that's the thing. It's not that hard if you just study history. Let's go ahead and talk to Jim in Washington. You're on the air with our former CIA insider. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex, really appreciate your show. And Mr. Steele, I have a two-point question regarding constitutional convention. First of all, since our cheating culture is not obeying the Constitution now, what makes anyone think that a couple of more amendments are going to make any difference? And secondly, once a constitution is constitutional convention is started, it becomes an entity unto itself. And like the first one and only one that we've had was out of control. And since the elite have plans for a constitutional convention like this, how do you plan on controlling such
absolutely
an
I've always been against it for those reasons. We're in such we're in such dangerous straits now. All I'm saying is that if it's led by patriots from the beginning, we can control it. We can have dry runs as well. And then we can sit there and, you know, try to actually fix the country and use it as a way to educate the public with leadership against the culture of corruption. But the caller's right. If we are a fallen society, maybe we're like Humpty Dumpty and can't be put back together again. Go ahead.
It comes back to state rights. I mean, first off, the Constitution has been undermined by some of these amendments. This whole Electoral College thing is a huge mistake, in my view.
The 17th Amendment getting rid of the senators.
Exactly. And the 12th Amendment, the 14th Amendment.
The 16th to give us the IRS. It all happened in 1913 with the last CONCON.
Right. Now, let me make the comment that I'd
rather... So how about a CONCON to reverse the last CONCON?
I'd actually like to have a CONCON that is out of control with the public being out of control rather than a CONCON that's out of control with the elites being out of control. I have more faith in the average American than I do in our elite.
I'll say this. Desperate times mean desperate means. They're ignoring it all anyways. I just say throw it all into hell and let God sort it out.
Let's have a national conversation.
I've never agreed with this, and I'm not sure I completely do now. I'm just saying I really know Greg Abbott's for real. We're already dying on the table here. I don't know what else we can do. But Mr. Steele, great debate. Jim, great points, Jim. Thank you so much. I hear you. I totally understand your points, and I'm looking at both. Mr. Steele, thank you so much.